All right, ladies and gentlemen, as I was saying in that, this unit here begins one of the final units in your final trimester. This is going to be intro to quadratic functions. We're going to split this up into two half units, just like we have for the last couple of units here. But this is going to be one of the most important units we do all year. So lots of information on this. Let's get started. A quadratic function, you should have heard that term before, quadratic. Quadratic refers to degree two polynomials. So a quadratic function is one whose degree is two. Its graph has a U sort of a shape, so it's a round graph, and we formally call that a parabola. So that's the first key term I really want you to know in this unit, besides quadratic function, is parabola. That is the graph of a quadratic function, and that's what we're going to be focusing on for these next several videos, is learning how to graph parabolas, learning how to graph those quadratic functions. The form of a quadratic equation is this. This is the standard form. F of x equals a squared plus bx plus c. Okay, notice the exponent of 2 there. That makes it a degree 2. Okay, the largest exponent is a 2. So here are some examples of quadratic equations that you might see in this unit. You might see something like y equals x squared plus 5. Okay, that would be a good example of a quadratic equation because its largest exponent is a 2. You could also have something that looks like this. Y equals 7x squared would be a quadratic equation. You might also have f of x equals negative 1 half x squared minus x plus 3. So you can have fraction coefficients in quadratic equations as well. Some general information about quadratics. Another couple of terms I want you to know for this unit. The first is what's called the axis of symmetry. This is the imaginary line that divides a parabola into symmetrical halves. Okay, the imaginary line that divides a parabola into symmetrical halves. You'll notice that parabolas do have symmetry. That means if we fold them over that imaginary vertical line, they're going to be identical. Okay, so I have two graphs of parabolas down here for you to take a look at. And if I wanted to draw in the axis of symmetry for these parabolas, they would be these imaginary lines, which is why I'm using dashes, that go right there down the middle of the parabola. Okay, that's what I mean by an axis of symmetry. Okay, we also have what's called a vertex. Okay, that's another key term that we're going to use a lot in this unit, is that term vertex. And when I'm referring to the vertex of a parabola, I'm referring to the highest or lowest point on the parabola. Okay, the highest or the lowest point on the graph. So a vertex is a point, meaning we use ordered pairs, parentheses, to describe a vertex. Okay, so for this parabola right here, you'll notice that this parabola opens upwards. Okay, parabolas can either open upwards or downwards. And so for this parabola right here, it opens upwards, and thus the vertex is the lowest point on the graph. That's the vertex right there. Assuming you have an equation in standard form, okay, this y equals ax squared plus bx plus c, your leading coefficient, which is, again, the coefficient in front of the x squared term, in this case a, if it is positive, that means the parabola is going to open upwards. Okay, just like this graph right here, if a is positive, your parabola opens upwards, meaning your vertex is the lowest point, or we call that a minimum. Okay, if the parabola opens downwards, like this graph here on the right, that means that the a value must have been negative. Your leading coefficient was negative. So that's what makes a parabola open downwards, and that would make the vertex, which on this graph would be right here, that would make that vertex a maximum. It's the highest point on the graph. Okay, kind of like having a hill here and a valley here. When the parabola opens upwards, the vertex is a minimum. When the parabola opens downwards like this, the vertex is a maximum. I also want you to remember what the term y-intercept means. Y-intercept is where a graph crosses the y-axis. So on this parabola right here, this point looks like about 0.5 would be the y-intercept. And on this graph, it would be this point right here. That looks like about 0.-5. Okay, so the first thing I want to look at in this lesson is just how to identify a vertex. So if you'll flip over the page, I've given you two graphs. You'll see in examples 1 and 2. And in these graphs, we're just going to do two things. We're going to identify the vertex using an ordered pair, and then we're going to tell whether it's a maximum or a minimum. So number 1 here, your vertex would be this point right here, and that is the point -2, +1. Okay, so our vertex is -2, +1. And it's the lowest point on the graph, so that means that our vertex is a minimum. Okay, number 2, the vertex would be right here at the tip. 3, 2 would be that point. So the vertex is at 3, 2. And in this case, it's the highest point on our graph, so this vertex here is a maximum. Okay, now in examples 3 through 5, these last few examples, we're actually going to practice graphing these parabolas. We're going to do that using a table of values. So you'll see here in number 3, I'm giving you the function f of x equals x² + 3. And I've given you 5x values that I just want you to plug in 4x to that function to get the y values. Okay, we did this a little bit last year. It's been a while since we've graphed using a table. Actually, we did it with exponential functions as well. So if you plug in a -2 for x, that's going to be -2, make sure you use parentheses around it, squared +3. So you have to do a little bit of order of operations. -2² is +4. And then when you add 3 to that, you get 7. Okay, so when x is -2, y is equal to 7. When I plug in -1, that'll be -1² + 3, which is +1 + 3. 1 + 3 is 4. When I plug in 0 for x, 0² is 0. 0 + 3 is 3, so I have a point 0, 3. 1² would be 1, and 1 + 3, you get 4 again. And then finally, when I plug in +2, I'll do 2² + 3, 2² is 4, add 3, I get 7. Okay, so what we're gonna do now that we have those y values is we're gonna plot each of those x, y points on this graph over here, and hopefully we'll get a parabola shape when we're finished. So my first point is -2, 7. That would be left 2 and up 7 from the origin. My next point is -1, 4. Then I have 0, 3, which is also a y-intercept because it's on the y-axis. So there's 0, 3. 1, 4. And then finally 2, 7. So at first glance, if you're looking at those dots, it may seem like that would be a V shape, but keep in mind this is a quadratic function. It has to graph a parabola, and a parabola is a curve. So we need to make sure when we're connecting these points here that we make it as smooth as possible. These are not straight lines. This is a curve graph. So we're going to connect those points now, and that's how you graph a parabola. Okay, you can just plug in x values in order to get the y values. Okay, so now let's look at number 4, and we'll graph f of x equals x² - 4x + 4. Okay, this time I've given you different x values, 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4, but the process is going to be the same. We're going to plug in the x value and do order of operations to get the y value. So when I plug in 0, I have to plug it in two places. I have to plug it in for my x² and then also right there in the middle for my 4 times x. So this is going to be 0² - 4 × 0 + 4. You do your exponent first, 0² is 0, -4 × 0 = 0, + 4, so we just get a 4 for y. When I plug in a 1, that's going to be 1² - 4 × 1 plus 4. Okay, 1 squared is 1. Negative 4 times 1 is negative 4, so minus 4. And then plus 4. Well, 1 minus 4 is negative 3. Plus 4 would be positive 1. Okay, so positive 1 for y there. When I plug in 2, that would be 2 squared minus 4 times 2 plus 4. 2 squared is positive 4. Negative 4 times 2 is minus 8. And then we have the plus 4 at the end. So we have 4 minus 8 plus 4. 4 minus 8 is negative 4. Add 4, you get 0. Okay, and then 2 more. We'll plug in positive 3. So 3 squared minus 4 times 3 plus 4. This gives you 9 minus 12 plus 4. 9 minus 12 plus 4 comes out to be positive 1. And when I plug in 4, 4 squared minus 4 times 4 plus 4, that's going to be 16 minus 16 plus 4. You know, for Mr. Worling's class, 16 minus 16 is 0. And then you add 4 and you get 4. So we have 4 for our y value there. So I'm going to plot all these points now, starting with 0, 4. That's going to be right there on the y-axis. 1, 1 would be right 1 and up 1 from the origin. 2, 0 would be right here. 3, 1 would be up 3 and right 1 from the origin. And then 4, 4, right 4, up 4. So again, you get that nice U-shape. And again, make sure you connect those dots so that they come out to be curves. All right, last one. Now we have f of x equals negative 2x squared minus 4x plus 1. So I'm going to go ahead and show you how to plug in negative 3, and then after I do that, I'm going to have you pause the video, and then you're going to go through and do those other four values on your own. So when I plug in negative 3, I'm going to plug it in just like this. I'm going to do my exponents first, so we have to do that negative 3 squared first, which is positive 9. And then we'll do negative 4 times negative 3, which gives us positive 12. So this is negative 2 times 9, which is negative 18 plus 12 plus 1. Negative 18 plus 12 is negative 6. Add 1, you get negative 5. So negative 5 for your first y value. I want you to plug in the other four now. Go ahead and pause the video to do that. Really be careful with your order of operations, and once you have your table filled out, click play to check and see if you got your y values correct. Okay, so let's take a look and see what you got for your y values. My work is kind of cramped here, but hopefully you can see that. So for negative 2, again, you have to remember to do the exponent part first. So negative 2 squared is positive 4. Okay, and then when we do our multiplication, negative 2 times 4 is negative 8. In the middle, we have a negative 4 times negative 2, which is positive 8, so be careful with your signs. And then we have our plus 1. So really we have negative 8 plus 8 plus 1, which I put over here is positive 1. Okay, and then the rest of the work follows suit. You end up with negative 2 plus 4 plus 1 when you plug in negative 1. So you get a y value of 3. 0, one of the easiest numbers to plug in all of these. You get 0 minus 0 plus 1, which is 1. And then positive 1, you get negative 2 minus 4 plus 1, which gives you negative 5. So again, you can tell whether or not your table is right based on the graph you get, because again, you should be getting a U-shaped graph. So let's take a look at this one here. You'll notice the A value in this one is a negative. The leading coefficient's negative 2. So remember what I told you on the front side of the notes, that if your A value is negative, your parabola should be opening downwards. So hopefully this one does that. Let's see, negative 2, 1 we did, negative... negative 2, 1 would be right there, my fault. Negative 1, 3 would be right up here. Okay, and then we have 0, 1, and 1, negative 5. And so this is another good shape. It does open downwards, which is a good thing. Again, you want to make these as smooth of curves as possible. Okay, so I'll take any questions you have over this the next time I see you, and then in the next couple videos we'll learn some more methods for how to graph these functions. Until I see you next time, have a nice day. You're all wonderful people. Take care.